Hi, I'm Drew.
And I'm Kathy.
And we're in Seekonk, Mass.
Yay, bottle show.
Saturday, June 10th, 2023.
Let's look at some bottles.
Okay.
Let's buy some bottles.
Let's sell some bottles.
Yeah. Hello. I'm always looking for the little bottles now.
I see some familiar faces, and there's also a lot of new ones.
Been digging up a lot, so dug a few poisons. Those are always fun.
Oh yeah.
Already sold my nicer one.
Some nice poisons. Reasonably priced. Yep, shopping dome.
And we're having one of those with the label on it, and I think some of the pills in there still.
Oh, wow.
I forget what it was, but not to be taken.
Right. Oh, okay.
I think that one's out of Connecticut.
Nice embossing.
Yeah, this is one of my favorite ones I dug too.
That's been a good place there. Well, yeah. Look at that.
Crack, but it's much more affordable than the intemperate ones.
There's another one with nice embossing.
There are a lot of Quakers in Rhode Island, so it became a popular theme for while there's another commercial businessman. He was a Quaker. And you know, Quaker Rose, of course. That's the one everyone recognizes, but it's lesser known.
That is definitely a different Indian than we have on ours.
Yeah, I've seen a few variants.
Yep.
I think I'm debating whether I should tumble that, because I think it'll look nice if I get it clean, so we'll see.
Huh. The queen.
Yeah.
Well, that's a different queen jar.
That's an older one. It's got patent dates in the vase, little olive swirl.
Oh, yeah.
I was told, you see those olive swirls? That's usually an oil got in the mold by accident. So typically you'll see it in the bottom or the top. That's where the oil would usually be. I dug one of those recently, not those are funnels. I dug a smooth-based one, it's square, which really odd to see a square cologne.
Huh.
They usually have that kind of fancier shape to them.
Right. Oh, the potato.
Yep.
I have the big potato and the little potato.
Oh, the two sizes, that's cool.
Yep.
Nice. These are always fun with the armored hand on them. Derpies are usually very common, but this version is a little more interesting. dug that one recently.
Oh, nice.
Leonard's bottle show that is, right?
Yes, we had one in May. And that was usually this was in July, but we had them close together, so
it's basically
it's cooler out when it wasn't really a
good thing. I wore like just soccer first and a t-shirt and that's so cold. And the weather this week has been kind of crappy too, so I think we caught the best of it.
Yeah, this is potentially the nice day. So.
Can I take
a
look?
All right, so here's the book I finally got out late last year. I've been working on and off close to 8 years working on it, but it only took probably less than a year of full research and photography, and just ACL soda bottles from Rhode Island. So there's only maybe 250, including variants and sizes. But so I have every company, all the complete history, where they were, who the owner was, different brands they bottled. A lot of them were local bottlers bottling like Coca-Cola or Pepsi. For like the larger chains. And this is the list. All the different names, all the variants, and how to identify the variants. So I have all those, and then the best part, of course, at the end is all the photos. These took the longest time to come across. I had to photograph mine, visit my friends' collections. I got a few from collectors, in California. Had examples, they sent photos, and so just all different kinds.
All color pictures too.
Yep.
Nice.
Front and back photos.
Wow.
Yeah, so a lot of variants. Like this page, from here on, all the same yacht club.
Amazing.
And that's it, yeah.
Okay. And that is available?
I'm selling on Amazon if you're not local. I think it's $25, and I'm selling in person for $20. So.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you.
For my mom, I don't know if you remember.
Okay, yeah.
Just three right now. So. More than merrier.
Yeah, I dig a lot in this big dump that they uncovered during the investigation. And I pulled out a poop jar. She has one over there. Let me shake it, I want to see it. It's like a handful of
them. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I dug one in the pair. Apparently, the pair was worth like hundreds.
Awesome.
And I was like, I dug the lake.
Nice black glass bottles there. look at the size of this larkin. Wow. This is different. Dr. Bell's Pine Tar Honey Whiskey. That's cute. Next table. Wow. I would almost call that honey pumpkin. Honey pumpkin. I think I invented that.
A new TV show.
There's a nice bottle.
light amber. It's a square corner. It's an earlier one. It's a very crude applied top. And it's the kind of thing that's like, I'd rather have that than spend cash on a real one. That's right. I just love it. I've always loved the bottles.
Crude little bottle. I have one of these, but not like this one. This is Dr. H. A. Ingham's Nervine Pain Extractor.
Nervine Pain Extractor.
Yeah, I've got one, but not like this. Look at the lip.
It's early smooth base.
Yeah.
Seam goes all the way across.
Yeah, look at the lip.
Yeah.
And it's got some little green bits in the glass.
It's outwardly rolled and folded. Rolled flip lip.
Neat. I like it. Marbles, but they look new, at least some of them. Mostly cat eyes and clearies. Oh well. Had to check them out. Actually, that one's kind of neat. But I don't know. I really don't want all of these. A larkin full of old nails. That's different. That's a lot of lozenges.
Out of 12.
Maybe that is a marble. Yeah, I thought it was a paperweight. I think it's actually a marble. Let's go around the other way. Oh, those are nice.
So, you know, you just have to pick it up and go.
Look at that. That's a beauty.
Maybe that's what it was.
Wish the sun would come back out. But this one is aqua. And this one is almost cornflower blue, maybe. Very close. Periwinkle, maybe. Very nice. $250 on that one. That's $250, by the way. And I don't see a price on the smaller one. Oh, too bad. This has an issue. Just a tiny issue. Oh, it's gorgeous. I have a collection of these fancy colognes, but I don't have this one. Oh, that's so nice. Here's the $1,000 bottle.
I've got a ton of those bottles at home, but
Not one that big, and not one with that, that name on it. It's a Boston one, but it's a different name. It's been out there.
Oh, a decision needs to be made.
You don't, you also have the other one of not buying anything. You don't have to buy anything.
Oh, that's not an option.
You could show it to the husband with his opinion. You kind of know he's going to rule out that one. But.
Yeah, and then if I still want it, I'm going to buy it anyway, so that doesn't really help asking.
But as you probably know, if that was perfect, it would be quite a lot more money, so that's why it's that price.
Yeah.
Because it's not perfect. Yeah. I bought it thinking it was perfect and found it later.
Oh no.
It happens.
Yes, it does.
Let's see if we have some pictures from here.
Carl has the best stuff.
Thank you, Kathy. Always good to see you at the bottle shows.
Well, I could not decide between these two. This one, it's nice, but I really love these two. I'm getting both of them.
So you're interested in the fragments. We excavated these at the Boston Sandwich Glass Factory. It started in 1820s until they went out of business in the 1880s. And it's slag glass, green and white colors mixed together.
pretty interesting. It's almost the color of money, but
it was
down about 3 feet down some right behind where the original buildings were for the old part of the factory.
Could go back to the 1820s or 30s or 40s, I'm not sure.
Oh, nice. Look at that.
That's beautiful. You want a few pieces for your garden?
Oh, for my garden? That's too good for my garden.
You're welcome to.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah. Let's pick a couple of nice pieces here. That almost looks like a tree stump. Oh, good. We've got the sun. Oh, no, we don't have the sun. Oh, look at that. Wow. Oh. That's gorgeous. More decisions. Definitely this one.
There's
a glower.
There's a bunch of amber ones, but
there's a glower.
But there's about only a handful.
Look at this mayonnaise maker. I actually dug the glass part of this once. So that's what the whole thing looks like. Stump of the World, D.H. Gear and Son, Boston, Mass.
Holding that tree up?
Yeah. Tree is holding me up.
Yeah, I think these, I'm 99% sure these are Taunton.
Yeah, and this one too, the E. Williams.
Oh, that one definitely is. It's okay. He's in the business directory as a beer maker.
Okay.
First he worked at the brick, his family was in the brick making business, and then he was a beer maker for a while, and then he went to be farming. I know where his house was.
Oh, wow.
Where'd you get there, Mark?
I bought that from my car. Sometimes they get carried away. I don't need to do it. But we can all have our opinions, you know?
Look at this. Goff's No Dope Cough Syrup.
Definitely wasn't super focused on it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because if
you. Here's my card now, it's over next time.
Thank you.
you and they called you, you gotta run.
Yeah.
Like the minute, you're like the Minuteman, you're always prepared, right?
Yeah.
I just threw that on.
I didn't buy anything at the show, but I traded Taylor another Boston beer for this one. It says Con Keefe, 8 and 10 Cambridge Street, Boston. I like this bottle because it goes with two others I have in my collection. This little flask, Con Keefe Family Liquor Store, 8 and 10 Cambridge Street, Boston, Mass, which we recently got from Jen Heatley. And this little mini jug, Con Keefe, 8 and 10 Cambridge Street, Boston, Mass. Look at how small it is. I got this off eBay. Long time ago.